If you're online with a device and you hover the mouse cursor over a wire, this happens. That is called a dynamic meter. Using dynamic meters, you can see actual audio level anywhere in the signal path in real time. As you can see, when I move the cursor away, the dynamic meter disappears. But if I click anywhere on the dynamic meter, that pins it down so it stays in place. By default, only two dynamic meters can appear simultaneously, but you can change that to a maximum of 20 within the properties of the physical device. It's worth noting that dynamic meters are troubleshooting tools only, and they cannot show up on any control system. For that, you would either use the existing meters in the input or output cards, or you would insert a meter processing object anywhere in the block diagram. Another nice software feature is mute indication at the block diagram level. For example, I'll add a new mixer and I'll change it to 4 channels just for simplicity. These 5 red dots are mute indications. Without even opening the control panel, I know that all 4 inputs and the master output are muted. If I open the control panel and change the state of the mutes, these changes are reflected in real time at the block diagram. And it works both ways, meaning I can control the mutes by clicking directly on the red dots. The red dots, combined with dynamic meters, combined with signal naming, makes even complex designs very easy to build and work with. Thanks for watching these videos. I'm Kevin Brown with BSS Audio, and I'll see you next time.